What's going on, everybody? Now, this is going to be a serious video. As you see, I usually do the parodies and such, but this one's going to be very serious. We're going to be talking about the YouTube shooter and the hidden secrets of YouTube. Why? What could really lead a person to do such a thing? I'm going to be honest, everything I say in this video, I am not condoning this shooting at all. At the end of the day, there is no excuse for you to have to run up in anywhere and take away people's lives. There's really no excuse for that. So, that being said, now let me tell you guys about the evils of YouTube overall. I used to be a sub network owner. I had a pretty successful company. It was called Cableline Network. That's why I still have the YouTube channel name, Cableline Network. Now, I had about 700 partners in there. I treated people with respect. I even had a Twitch program where I was paying live streamers so they can make money. I wasn't even making money off the program, but I did it because I had it. June 10th of 2016, YouTube actually decides to kill my company. They literally decide to shut down the entire sub network community. And then they had the audacity to say something about they investigated us. Yet there was never an investigation for me. Never. I was never investigated. I was never being red flagged for anything. Literally. I remember a time to where YouTube actually said you have to have another business besides just having a YouTube network if you want to continue to have a YouTube network. Well, that's why I had the Twitch business and such like that, where I could pay people. Now, in saying this, they shut that down in an instant. All those years of work gone. Then with the 4K 1K rule, then with the 200,000 partner purge that happened, all of my life's work is gone. Do you know how that feels? To have literally your entire life just ripped from you? Not because of anything you did, but because I actually don't know the reason. Maybe it could have been greed. I'm just not sure. But YouTube has been doing some extremely dirty shit to people. Now, you should, of course, have self-control enough not to run up with a gun in someone's office and do that. But at the end of the day, what can you do when you don't have any option? Now, you're talking about that girl had 300,000 views for a video and she only got paid 10 cents? That's robbery. YouTube was directly, there's no way in hell. Guys, I've been on YouTube since 2009. There's no way in hell. No way in hell that you get 300,000 views and you get 10 cents for it? Guys, that's some type of BS going on, right? Honestly, from what it looks like, YouTube is directly stealing certain content creators' money. Like, there's no way that you get 10 cents for 300,000 views. There's no way. When that girl showed that picture, I couldn't believe it. Somebody is stealing money. Somebody is hemorrhaging money. I don't know who it is, but somebody is definitely doing that in YouTube. I actually have another one. So they don't show all your videos to all your subscribers. And then when they made the video, they looked over to each other and said, that makes sense, right? And they were like, yeah. Are you fucking serious? You literally are screwing people over and you don't believe yourself it makes sense? Are you effing serious, man? That's twisted. Like, that literally is twisted as hell there. Like, that makes me think, what else is YouTube doing behind the scenes? I remember a time where YouTube used to let the actual networks control your account, favorites, and everything. They used to allow that. YouTube has done some pretty dirty practices in the past. Like, okay, 4K, 1K, for example. There was no reason for you to shut off partnership for that many people. The partner curling, there was no reason for you to cancel 200,000 partnerships. People need to feed their families. When the sub network thing collapsed, I knew sub network owners that actually had to sell their house, that actually could not feed their families. They actually went on type of drugs and such. People actually have offed themselves. You were talking about these people have devastated thousands of lives, thousands, and they laughed it off. They're still laughing. Well, I don't know if they're laughing now, but when that partner curling happened, the sub network collapse happened, they were laughing. They were looking to directly destroy people. Because at the end of the day, I don't care what nobody says, this is a job. You are putting time and effort into something that's generating money to a company. That is the pure definition of a job. You can't say YouTube is not a job. How can you say YouTube is not a job? What do? Usually the people that say YouTube is not a job usually flip burgers. They don't work at all. Or they are basically neets. There's no education, no training, no accomplishments. that's basically what Neat is. It's a big thing that's going around right now, but you're talking about people like that criticizing people for wanting to make content to enjoy themselves. And another thing too, YouTube partners with you. It's a partnership. Isn't that a job? If I'm in partnership with you to do something, isn't that a job? Unless you're married or something, then a partner, blah, blah, blah. But that's still a job. Why? I don't understand why YouTube constantly does this. Right now, I had a video that was going actually viral and such. Gohan, the guy who does reactions to my content all the time, he basically got his video stricken down because of community guidelines violations when it was a joke about breastfeeding. Yet you have Logan Paul who can post dead bodies and still be in a pervert program. Are you effing serious? Guys, just look around. There's been constant creators that have expressed this problem. You shouldn't do this. If I'm at a job so many years and now you're saying, okay, well, we're going to cut half of your money because certain advertisers don't like it. The reason why you lost advertisers was because of the Wall Street Journal, stupid ass. That was the reason why you lost a ton of advertisers at the end of the day. And it's because of your bigger channels, not your smaller ones, not the 90,000, not the 10,000, not the 50. You're talking about the 20 million people like Logan Paul, who, like PewDiePie, who literally made a video where he made a joke about saying, I hate Jews or something with Jews should die. You made a video like that. What the fuck? Big people like that. PewDiePie lost Machinima a deal, a brand deal, because of his content with Levi's. That's why, well, one of the reasons why PewDiePie is no longer with Machinima. PewDiePie himself has lost Machinima brand deals. These major accounts are losing you brand deals, not the smaller ones. Not at all. Once again, a Wall Street Journal made that post about it was an advertisement on a racist video. And let's get into this before I end this video. Nobody in the history of any fucking where has ever attributed the company's policies and advertisements to the YouTube video. No way in hell. If I'm watching a video about some sick crap and an ad pops up, do you think I'm going to say, oh, well, Coca-Cola obviously supports this because this ad popped up? No. Nobody in the history of the planet thinks that. Nobody. No fucking body. Like, literally. So I'm not understanding where this logic is coming from, YouTube. You are constantly hurting people. You're laughing at our faces. We're getting upset. So I just wanted to say my piece about this whole thing. Make sure to comment about what you think, and I'll make sure to reply to it. Now, once again, I'm not condoning anything she did, because at the end of the day, there's no reason for you to run in there and do that. There really is not. You could be mad as hell. You could just work a little harder. But, man, that's crazy all around. All right, peace out. Organize your subscribers. We catalog views. We are the reason why this site is running.